Hello dear students, welcome to the online teaching session of Academic World School Bemitra. Today we are again here with the physics, that is science portion of class 10th. The topic that we are studying is magnetic effects of current, and today's topic is force on a current carrying conductor kept in a uniform magnetic field. So let's begin the topic today. I request all of you to take out your notebooks and pen and start noting down whatever is being taught from here. So ready? As you can see on the board, I have already drawn one diagram, circuit diagram of the setup of experiment number 13.7. Now this experiment is for your force on the current carrying conductor. Okay, so here this rod AB is the conductor. In this rod, I have connected two wires on the ends A and B, and they are connected with a cell. When I will switch on the key, this is key, then this battery will apply the potential. So because of this battery, one current will flow in the wire. Now let's follow the path. The current will go from here, and inside the conductor AB, the current will flow from A to B. There is a horseshoe magnet kept here. What is the use of horseshoe magnet? I told you in the previous one that horseshoe magnet has two poles, north and south, kept close to each other. So in between the two poles there is parallel lines, and they go from north and terminate at the south. So they form a uniform magnetic field, upward direction. So now when the conductor which is kept in a horseshoe magnet, it is like this. The horseshoe magnet is like a U-shaped magnet, and in between that the conductor AB is kept like this. You can see? Okay, so the current is going from A end to B end. In this condition, it is observed that the conductor starts bouncing onto the right hand side like this. It will feel one force. Now what is this force? This force has originated because of the electromagnetic effect. There is a magnetic field, and because when you press the key, the current also flows in the conductor which is kept in the field. So interaction of the magnetic field and electric field will produce one force. One jerk is experienced. This is called force. This experiment you will need to explain. So rewrite the experiment from the book 13.7, experiment number. What does it say? Take one horseshoe magnet, one rod, connect the two ends of the rod with the battery and key. When you press the key, the rod will experience one force. Okay, so this is the experiment by which we can prove that there is a force. Your question will be, describe experiment to show force due to a current carrying conductor . Okay, and this will be the experiment. Describe the experiment of force due to a current carrying conductor. So here we have seen that whenever one current carrying conductor is kept in a uniform magnetic field, then it feels one force. What is the direction of the force? On this side. Okay, so Now the question arises, is there a simple way by which we can find out where is the direction of the force? Yes. The simplest way is right hand. The simplest way is Fleming's left hand rule. Earlier you have learned about right hand thumb rule. Now this is another rule, Fleming's left hand rule. So Fleming was a scientist and he has given the rule for finding the direction. According to this, if you stretch your left hand, which is your left hand on this side, okay, so left hand, all of you raise. Now stretch your three fingers, forefinger, middle finger and thumb, such that they are mutually perpendicular to each other. You have to stretch forefinger, middle finger and thumb mutually perpendicular. They are all at 90 degree 90 degree 90 degree and 90 degree, okay? So all of them are 90 degree to one another. In this condition, if you keep the forefinger in the direction of the magnetic field and the middle finger in the direction of the current, then the thumb gives the direction of the force. Now here if you see, the magnetic field is upward, so I will keep the forefinger upward, okay, upward, and the middle finger is towards the inside. Middle finger will be inside. Here the direction of current is A to B, so A to B, I have kept the middle finger inside. Okay, so what is the direction of the thumb? Thumb is giving you the direction of the force. The conductor AB, which is kept, will feel one force in the direction of the thumb. As I told you, if this is the horseshoe magnet and here I keep the conductor will feel the force towards outside. Okay, on reversing the direction of the current, the direction of force will also change. It's vice versa. If you change the direction of current, the direction of force will also change. So there is the rule, Fleming's left hand rule. So write down, what is Fleming's left hand rule? Fleming's left hand rule says, according to Fleming's left hand rule, if you stretch the forefinger, middle finger and thumb mutually perpendicular to each other, then such that forefinger points towards magnetic field middle finger in direction of current, then thumb gives the direction of current. force. This is very important. Please write it in your copy. Please write this in your copy. According to Fleming's left hand rule, if you stretch the forefinger, the middle finger and thumb mutually perpendicular, means 90 degree to each other, such that the forefinger is pointing in the direction of the magnetic field and middle finger in the direction of the current, then the thumb gives the direction of the force. Thumb gives the direction of the force. Okay. I hope you have noted down this definition. It's very, very important. You can put a star mark here. Okay. So, if I ask you one question, that in your classroom or in your room where you are seated, if the magnetic field is from ground to upward, okay, and the electric current is flowing from your left hand side to right hand side, okay, then in which side, in which direction the force will be? Will it be towards front or towards back? Tell me the answer. The answer is backward side. See, the magnetic field is upward and the current is going from left to right. Okay, so the direction of the thumb is towards you, that is backward side. You will feel the force. Simple. You have to use your left hand properly with aligning the fingers in the direction of the given properties or physical properties. Okay, so this kind of question you can expect in the question paper. Okay, so what have we understood in this? We have understood in this that when a current carrying conductor like a rod is kept in a magnetic field, then one force is exerted on it. Force. Force is such an important thing that it makes the work done. So this was the first glorious event where we could convert the electricity into force. So here we got the chance that we can push something by electricity. And this was the important discovery to make so many important things which are based on that. First of all, I will tell you, which is in your home, is there any device which starts to move, shows some motion when you press the electricity or pass current? Yes, fan, under which you are studying. Okay, so fan is a device. The moment you press the key, the fan starts to move. This motion property was very, very important. So here comes the invention of force from electricity. These are called motor. Actually, fan is an application of motor. So we will now study the next topic, electric motor. As you know, students, there are many things in our surrounding which are using motor. Can you name some device that use motor? Fan, I will list them. Okay. Fan, CD player, cooler fan, mixer, grinder, washing machine, okay. So there are many devices in your home and surrounding where we use the electric motor. Electric motor is a important thing by which you can convert electrical energy into mechanical energy. So, right question. Name one device which convert electrical energy to mechanical energy. Name one device that converts electrical energy to mechanical energy. Answer is electric motor. Okay, you can be asked vice versa. What is an electric motor? Electric motor is a device that converts electrical energy into mechanical energy.
Okay.
What is the principle of electric motor? What is the principle of electric motor? Okay, electric motor works on which principle? The same question. What is the principle of electric motor, or what is the principle on which the electric motor works? The answer of this question is, the electric motor works on the principle that when a electric conductor, when a current carrying conductor is kept in a magnetic field, it experiences one force. Okay, so answer will be, when a current carrying conductor is kept in a magnetic field, it experiences a force. This is the principle of the working of electric motor. Okay, so let's see, what is the principle of electric motor, or on what principle does an electric motor work? So answer will be, when a current carrying conductor is kept in a magnetic field, it experiences a force. Stop. This is the principle of the working of electric motor. Please note it down. So now we move to a third question. You can write, what are the uses of electric motor? We have already discussed here. The uses of electric motor are fan, CD player, cooler fan, mixer grinder and washing machines. So as I have told you about electric motor, so we will first now draw the schematic diagram, or it is called the block diagram. We will not go in detail, as it is 10th class is a very young class. So we will study the block diagram of the block diagram of electric motor. Okay. So in any electric motor, there will be a magnetic field, and that magnetic field is produced by magnet. We need one magnet here. The two magnets we will be using, they will be permanent magnet, and they are called block magnets. So one will be facing the north pole and this side is facing the south pole. Okay, so this kind of faces facing each other, these are your block magnets. So two block magnets you need. Now in between that you need one conductor to move, so that will be this rectangular conductor. One rectangular conductor is required. Now this rectangular conductor, at the end there will be two split rings, half rings. These rings are named S1, S2. Okay. And these rings are connected with brushes B1. This is ring R1 and R2. Here B2. Okay. Now these two brushes are connected with a battery. And one key. All of you draw the diagram. This is the block diagram of electric motor. And what are the parts? Let me explain you what are the parts. The parts are block magnets. This is north pole and this is south pole. So the direction of the magnetic field will be like this. Okay. So this is a magnetic field. Then there is a conductor. The conductor has A, B corner, C corner and D corner. A, B, C, D. They are the four arms of this conductor. And there are two rings. This is divided in two rings, R1 and R2. And there are two brushes. Brushes are the contact making substances. Actually, the brushes are made up of graphite. You all have seen your pencil. You write with pencil. The lead, black lead of the pencil is the graphite, and you have studied in junior classes 7 and 8 that graphite is a conductor. One electrode of carbon, that is a good conductor. So we use the graphite as carbon brush B1 and B2. So they provide contact with these moving brushes. Without any fixed firm contact, they provide to conduct the current with the ring. Okay, you can elaborate it more. I will explain you how. This is like a half ring, like a cup shape. okay, just like to see they are moving, okay, and these are in contacts. Okay. So in electric motor what have we seen? We have seen what is electric motor, then we have seen the principle of electric motor, and thirdly we have discussed the main construction parts, What are the main parts? First is block magnet. These are the block magnets. Then rings. Number three, brushes. And number four is this ABCD coil, rectangular frame. Okay. So these are the major parts. The rings, which is a contact making thing, okay, so it is called commutator. Split rings are also called as commutator. Split rings, which provides one point from where the current can be absorbed here and passed on to the coil, that is called as commutator. Okay. So we now let's proceed to working parts, principle, and now the next step is what is the working of an electric motor. Working of motor. In the working of motor, let's imagine the first step where you have pressed the key. The moment you press the key, the current will start to flow from this positive terminal and it will come to the brush B1. B1 is in contact with R1, so current will go into the ring R1. From R1 it will come in the coil, and in the arm A it will flow from A to B to C and to D, and then again it will come back to R2, and through that the circuit is complete. So in the first step, the current in the coil moves in the direction A, B, C, D. Okay. As you know, the magnetic field direction is from north to south. So when I apply the Fleming's left hand rule, the direction of magnetic field is towards north to south, and the current is going inward, A to B. So what will happen? The arm AB will go down, and here the arm CD, the direction of current in CD is from forward direction, C to D. Okay, so here what will happen? The current, the force will be upward. So there is a anti-clockwise rotation of the arm ABCD. The arm ABCD, AB will go down and CD will come up. Okay, so here the force will twist. It will act like a couple force. It will act like a couple force acting in opposite direction. One is going down, the other one going up. It is just like you open the bottle cap. How do you open? Like this. You rotate it. The same thing will happen here also. The arm will rotate. On rotation, after next half cycle, it will become the position of this ABCD will change, and now this D will come here, C will come here, here it is B, and now it is A here. Similarly, the R2 will come and change with R1, and R1 will become R2 will become R1. So it will be a complete 180 degree rotation of this rectangular coil. This is called as armature. From ring to coil, this connection is called armature. So armature will rotate by half turn, that is 180 degree, and thereafter the rings will change the position. Now what happens, in R2 the current will flow like this. Okay, so working of electric motor, in first step current flows A, B, C, D. R1 is in contact of B1. Okay, and R2 is in contact of B2. Due to the force, AB goes down and CD comes up. AB goes down and CD comes up. Therefore, there is a 180 degree rotation. After half cycle, after 180 degree rotation, now what will happen? The current will flow in the opposite direction, DCBA. So current flows DCBA. Now what happens? This CD will go down and AB will come up. Now CD goes down and AB comes up. You see, just opposite it is happening. In the beginning, AB was going down, CD was coming up. After half rotation, now CD goes down and AB comes up, and this cycle continues. This is how the motor keeps on moving. Okay, so what is the main important thing? The main important thing here is this ring. The ring is changing the direction of the current. Ring is half. After every half cycle, it loses the contact with one terminal and the other terminal it joins, due to which the current direction changes in the coil. Okay, so this is how the electric motor keeps on moving one direction. Okay, I hope if you will learn it 3-4 times, you will understand what is the working. I will repeat the working once again. Here there is a magnetic field, and armature ABCD is there, which is connected to rings R1 and R2. In the beginning, R1 is in contact with B1. When it moves, the direction of current is ABCD, due to which the force is working. The direction of force is understood by Fleming's left hand rule, which says magnetic field direction of current is towards inside, so the force will be downward on this side, and on the other side the direction will be upward, due to which they will turn by 180 degree. As soon as it comes 180 degree, now there is a the changing of these rings. Now rings R1, ring R2 comes in contact with B1, and R1 comes in contact with B2, due to which the direction of current changes. Now the current flows DCBA. So earlier CD was going up, now it will go down. AB will go up. So the rotation keeps on happening in one direction. Okay, what is the bigger thing? This is a block diagram. But if you want to produce bigger magnets, what things you have to take care? Okay, so how to make usable and bigger magnets? How to improve and make powerful motor? So powerful motors, to make them you have to take care of three things. First of all, increase the number of turns. Increase the number of turns in the coil. Second thing, you can replace this permanent magnet. You know, permanent magnet have their fixed magnetic strength, and if you want powerful magnet, what will you use? Electromagnet. So replace permanent magnet with electromagnet. Replace permanent magnet with electromagnet. And third thing, is this armature. You can use a soft iron core. Use soft iron core. Actually, soft iron is a material that increases the magnetic field property. So by using the soft iron in the core, you can use you can increase the power of the magnet. So these are the three things by which you can make powerful magnets. You increase the number of turns. Instead of 3-4 turns, you can make 100 turns, 1000 turns. You can increase the current also. So in this way, you can improvise the motor. I hope, dear students, you have understood today. I explained you that motor is a device where electrical energy is converted into mechanical. This is the most important place. And how that mechanical energy is useful? It is in the motor. You are using in your electric, that toy train, that motorized, some toys are there which are swinging. Okay, so all these things are with the help of the electric motor. I hope you have enjoyed today's learning, and now I request you to download the assignment from the ERP and positively submit them without any failure. I will be eagerly waiting for your assignments. Thank you.